2020 was a strong year for the U.S. wind industry. According to reports from the American Clean Power Association, the U.S. now has nearly 122 gigawatts of operating wind power. That's enough to power about 38 million homes. Here to talk with us more about it is John Hensley. He's the Vice President of Research and Analytics for the American Clean Power Association. John, thanks for joining us.
Hey, thanks for having me.
All right, so 2020 was a tough one for so many businesses around the country. How important was last year for wind power? Obviously, when we're talking about the ability now to power more than 30 million homes.
Yeah, I think, you know, despite all the challenges that we saw from COVID-19, the clean energy industry were a bright spot for the economy. In fact, across the country, we saw more than 6,000 wind turbines that were installed. And just to give you a little bit of context, each of these wind turbines can power more than 890 American homes. So a tremendous amount of new clean energy that we're adding to the grid. And of course, it's not just about the clean energy and the environmental benefits. It's also about those economic value that these projects are creating as well, in terms of supporting jobs, as well as investing in local economies across the country.
What's the demand right now for wind energy, and has that demand changed with a change in the White House?
Yeah, I think demand for wind and other clean energy technologies continues to grow. Customers really like this product. They're wanting to power their homes and their businesses with clean energy, and wind and solar offer basically the cheapest form of new electricity available anywhere. And so it not only makes economic sense, but it also is a customer preference thing. We're seeing corporates get in on the action as well. Companies like Google, Walmart, Facebook, and others are increasingly looking to wind and solar and other renewable technologies to power their businesses with this clean energy. And of course, the Biden administration has put a big focus on clean energy and really driving emissions down in pursuit of climate impact reduction. And this industry, wind plus solar and energy storage, stand ready to help be part of that solution.
You mentioned jobs, and that's something that a lot of folks in 2020 were worried about when they were losing jobs because of the pandemic. How many jobs right now could wind be basically starting because of what is happening and the demand?
Yeah, great question. So today there are about 120,000 wind jobs across the country. Once you add in solar and energy storage, we're looking at about 300,000 jobs. And looking forward, we're actually, as an industry, targeting a majority renewables energy grid by 2030. Now, a couple of great things that will come along with that as we think about stimulus and economic growth that the country needs is that that industry will drive $1 trillion in new investment across the country and will support nearly a million American jobs around the country. Add on to that a 60% reduction in carbon emissions from adding all this new renewable energy to the system, and the future looks very bright for clean energy.
Let's talk about that future. 2021, what does it look like for renewable energy?
Yeah, I think there'll still be some lingering challenges from the COVID-19 impacts as we try to adjust supply chains, get folks out to the sites to build these new projects. But the momentum is there and it's growing. Again, customers want this product. The economics are very favorable and there's long-term policy support in place. And so we expect 2021 to be a good year and a year that helps us climb towards that majority renewable grid by 2030.
Great information, John Hensley. We appreciate you taking the time. Thank you so much here on News Nation.
Yeah, thanks for having me.